name was Captain Swaggersword, the bravest buccaneer, who raided other pirates and made them quake with fear. He buried all his booty in a far and distant land, locked safely in a treasure chest beneath the silky sand. But then the captain vanished. I don't know where or when. His treasure lost forever and never seen again. Well, that is, see you now.
Practise, come get your practise. Top of the muscles, alive, alive, oh, here he is.
Pirates! Well, they're nothing but dirty, rotten scoundrels! Redbeard.
Most fierce pirate of the seven seas.
Redbeard? But his beard is bright pink.
What did he say, Louie?
He said he feared he might sink.
Don't say the P word in front of the captain, laddie. Tends to make him mighty mad.
Sink? Never. Why, we're the fiercest, scariest.
Get here!
Pirates in the land.
We're compass of crumpets of grog. Curry and beans for everyone.
Curry and beans?
That's right, yeah, for everyone.
Curry and beans is all we eat. It's our favourite meal.
We even named our ship after
it. That's right. We're the pirates of the curry bean.
Doesn't that make you a bit, well, smelly?
Right, Missy. We cannot out our enemies with a single breath.
And wherever we sail, we always have the wind behind us.
Thank you.
captain says the wench must have stashed the map in her safe. Where's the safe?
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 Oh, there's the safe.
Oh, there's the safe.
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 Where's the safe?
Where's the safe?
Light the dynamite.
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 Thank you.
surgeon you'll ever find, sir.
That's right. Sore finger, aching ear, gammy leg. I can get rid of all of those.
You can cure all those?
No, I just cut them off.
Sounds too risky.
That's a shame, lads.
tankards, which means you've taken the king's shilling and been pressed ganged into my crew.
Look, he's right. You devious codfish.
Oh dear, I've swallowed mine.
How do you feel?
Like a slot machine.
Maybe I should clear her up and hope for a jackpot.
Either way, you're now a member of my crew, whether you like it or not. Now get over to the Crunchy Frog. We're about to set sail.
Time and tide waits for no man, not even you. We'll get you back to
but I'm afraid we're not due back until 17:30.
We'll have to wait till tea time.
No, the year's 17:30. In 2 years. But in the meantime, you can help sort out all our health and safety issues.
Well, we did find one problem.
You seem to be an expert.
Now, crew, prepare to drill.
treasure box on this city map.
What kind of you to let us go on?
Treasure? That's all you pirates think about, is it? I knew that map would be trouble. Why can't you give up this clever ignorance and become respectable? Like what I am.
Never. I'm addicted to pirating ever since the day that crocodile bit off my hand.
He's been hooked ever since.
I see. And tell me, how the pirates you are.
That be a tragic tale indeed. You see a seagull pooped in it.
You can't lose an eye because of seagull poop.
You can if you wipe it with your wrong hand.
Yes, very true. Now get me off this ship.
Thing is, my crew are very good at many things. Pillaging, fighting, saying ah very loudly. But they can't cook or sew or clean. In short, we could use a wench such as yourself to keep the ship shape during our voyage. Then I'd take them back to London when we found the treasure. Is it a deal? Do my boys get to throw you overboard?
Let me think about it.
Squawk, my fiddly wench. Isn't she a handsome woman?
Is your eye patch on the wrong eye?
I have the notion to make you his pirate wife after we get this here treasure. So, my dear, what's your answer?
Very well, but one trip only, then straight back to London. Good. My jackaboyser will be wondering where I am. And look at me. I'm not even dressed for a sea voyage. No makeup, no posh frock. I should have slipped into something long and flowing.
Like this one, River?
Nonsense, you're a fine figure of a woman. My good eye fellow would fling out your eyes. You would blush and fling out your cheeks.
And if it sneezed, would rip out your teeth.
I see. And tell me, what powder would suit my face?
Gun powder.
I haven't got here to be insulted.
Really? Where do you usually go?
Come, Reggie. Oh, I'm settled. There's been rumblings. Down below.
Must be that furry and beak.
No, they say the voyage is cursed, Captain. You must know it's bad luck to sail a woman aboard. We'll all be doomed.
Bow to that shoemaker fine addition to the crew. Now get the lads out there.
All pirates on deck! All pirates on deck! Look lively, you scurvy dogs.
Mrs. Pillywinkle here has kindly agreed to be our onboard housekeeper.
But she's a woman!
That's a good point, Paddy Wrinkle.
Make sure, could you whip me up a big year too?
We don't want to go wet to board that gate.
Tis bad luck to sail with a woman on our ship.
We'll be doomed!
We'll be doomed!
Doomed! Ship ahoy!
Ship ahoy!
A ship? How exciting!
I've never seen a ship before.
You're already on a ship, sir.
Oh, yes! Silly me. Now hand over the telescope and let me look.
Well, I think it might be better if I use the telescope.
Who's Admiral?
You are, sir.
A ship captain, due west.
Let me see. Well, well, well. Looks like we might have a little sport on our way to the treasure.
Well, what do you see?
A ship! A tiny little ship! An itsy-bitsy-teeny little ship! Oh!
You've got it the wrong way round.
A ship? An enormous ship! A gigantic, obvious ship! Put that poppy thing up!
They place their flag. It's a naval ship. Should we blow another water cannon? Not so fast. They might have some decent grog and gum on board. Let's just scare them with a skull and crossbones.
They face a flag too. How exciting!
What is it?
It looks like a big smiley face. They want to be friends. Goody! Now I can use those simple flags I made earlier. Raise my special message of greeting.
What do they say?
They say, who are you chaps fancy popping over for a cup of tea and a burger of fish? Do you guys think of why?
I think they're applying.
Think of your mothers. Think of your duty.
them out yet?
No.
Still no change.
You said that last time, you fool. You're not funny, you know?
What are you doing here? I thought you'd become pirates.
Oh, no. We've changed our minds, haven't we, Slap?
Yes. They wanted us to pay for our own pirate earrings. How much?
A buccaneer. I hope they are planning to torture you.
How?
Make you walk across 50 bottles of wine.
Really?
Yes, they call it walking the plonk.
But don't worry, we've got to rescue you.
Excellent, they've chained us up. But if you follow the chain and pull it, we can all get out of here.
Don't worry, I never lock things up.
Have you found the end, Slap?
I found the end, Scuttle!
Well, give it a big pull.
What have you done, you fool? We'll see! Put it back in, quick! It won't go back in!
Don't worry, it's only a little hole. We'll be alright, as long as we don't meet a storm.
Thank you.
really awful place.
Really? Where?
Practise.
Oh! Look, the treasure map!
Brilliant, Grog! Now we can go treasure hunting!
Oh dear me, that sounds very risky and unsafe. Rubbish! All we need to do is follow the treasure map and we'll all be rich.
And look! Here's some friendly tour guides to help us out!
They're not tour guides, they're...
Thank you.
your teeth is
good. And now you're all going to die.
Die?
Yes, you must all be executed.
Executed?
But why? We've done nothing wrong, your worshipfulness.
You have broken the one sacred law of Lombardo. Not treasure hunting. Pirates and treasure are forbidden here. And you have violated this rule. But I will be merciful.
Oh, thank you, your highness.
I will let you choose the method of your death. You can be burned at the stake or have your heads chopped off.
What a choice. Stake or chopped.
Or shot and gone.
That's no good. I don't wake up until 10 o'clock.
Now look here, Minga. Whatever. Whatever. We haven't gone all this way just to be executed. You may think you're chief of the Lombardo, but to me, you're just a pain in the neck.
Stop it! You're giving me a head off!
Hold up to our knees.
You know what they say.
Booty, sorry.
begun. And show myself from shoe to shoe, with bold adventures guaranteed. The finest crew you've ever seen.
The Pirates of the Caribbean!
Every year that I see our students do their production, I am blown away, and this year has been absolutely no exception. It's amazing to think that these young people are 11, 12 years old and are able to come up here and perform in such a fantastic way. So can we have another big round of applause? Big thank you to all of the mums and dads and the brothers and little sisters and grandmas and granddads and everyone else that's come along tonight. It is the audience that helps to make this a special time for these young people. Our production is something that we are very, very proud of, of course, they have been for many years. It is about our students our teachers, our parents and everyone getting together and making the best possible opportunity we can for these kids. It doesn't happen without a lot of hard work, and that hard work starts with our staff as well as our kids. So can I have a big round of applause, please? If we can help our staff come out, please. So, Mrs. Malik, Mrs. Miles, Mrs. Keogh. Lots and lots of hard work. And of course, doesn't happen without our wonderful music specialist being with us, with us for quite a while now. Mrs. Arnold, all of your hard work is really again, thank you for all of the work that you put into this. It is a special night for our kids and it's a special night for the parents as well, so thank you.
As Wayne said, obviously this is a huge undertaking, but we can't do it with everybody's support, and there's a few people that I'd like to make mention of in particular that actually emailed me in first term when I'd just taken on two jobs and said, we'd be happy to do sets and props when you do production. And I thought, I don't even have a production at the moment, I don't know what I'm going to do. Anyway, they were and have been absolutely fabulous right from the beginning to the end. So can I ask Louise Kramer and Talia Teo to come up on stage, please? Ladies were the creative designers of everything, absolutely everything, the beginning to the end, emails, you name it. And I would also like to call up Danny, who was in charge of all the costumes, the choir of children. Just quietly goes about the business, all right? Just a couple of things I'd like to mention out from these three wonderful ladies. On your program, you'll see that there's a list of people, and there was another list of people, but somebody that we left off was Wendy Brown, who was doing a lot of the hair. You can imagine with the pirates in particular, all of that. So could we please give her a round of applause? And every year we get to perform in this wonderful venue, and Troy is absolutely fabulous, and can we all give a big round of applause to Devin up there, who's been doing a lot. And a big round of applause for these kids who have been absolutely brilliant.
So there ends the production for 2017. Our year sixes, I've got sixes tonight, I was saying sevens last night, but that's because they were as good as year sevens. You did a fabulous job, year sixes, it was just wonderful. Brilliant to stand there, to sit back and have a really good laugh, as well as to see the great performances you put on.
all the screams in my brain. Oh, how I believed in my pain. Like you was my God. Look back and I saw the dark clouds. Took that and I made my mom proud. It's easy to jump when you know how to fall. Don't wanna sit around and wait, just hanging on a fantasy. I'm tryna be the kind of person who creates an energy. I hope I got the storm inside to maybe make a better me. Some people chalk it up to fate, I don't believe in destiny. I guess I had a spark inside I couldn't light when I was younger. Oftentimes I think you really need to fight to find the hunger. Lightning is the shine, but I've been working on the thunder.